Hi ladies, this is Tanya M and welcome back to my channel, Mommy on a Budget. So today we're gonna be discussing this unit right here. This is actually a synthetic unit, guys. Can you believe it? Yes, this is a synthetic unit. It's a very pricey synthetic unit. So I will be telling y'all exactly where it came from, why I decided to spend $109 on a synthetic unit. But as you can tell, the color is a pastel mixed with orange. Like if you look really closely, like there's a hint of like yellows and oranges and pinks to make this dusty rose color. And so as far as the construction of the unit, it comes with two combs in the front, adjustable straps. There's no comb in the back, which is kind of like a bummer to me because I don't use the combs in the front. I do use the comb in the back in case I want to put my unit up in a ponytail, a high ponytail. It holds it down. But that's an easy, quick fix that you can do for yourself, and which is just remove one of the combs here and sew it in the back. If, you know, that is a lot. If you're spending $109 on a unit, you're going to want the construction to be perfect. But hey, we can't always get what we want. So, so this is by a company or from a company called BeHairExtension.com. They sell human hair as well as the synthetic hair. So this is the unit that I purchased. And it is $91. However, there are some things that make the price go up, such as hair length, because you can choose your own hair length, your own hair density, the lace color, cap size, etc., etc. There is a spot where you can enter additional demands, like asking for a comb in the back. I always assume there's going to be combs in the back because when I purchase my normal beauty supply hair, units from companies like Sensational or Outre, Model, etc., etc., you know, they do come with the comb in the back. So I did have this unit for a while. I just applied it today. So I have kind of worn it around the house before, so I can't talk about the tangling. There is some tangling. As you can see, it did come with the little curls in the wig from the picture. It did come exactly like that. I did straighten out my wig because the curls for me, they can come off kind of wiggy. So I don't really like wearing curls, especially in a longer unit, unless it's a certain style that it gives. I know a lot of, like for example, if anybody's familiar with Zoresis Boss Wig, the curls gave it that boss look. So it wasn't like I wanted to flat iron those out. The layers were especially made in the wig for those curls. But this one, the curls are really unnecessary. And like I said, it gave it a wiggy look. I did test the wig on 300 degrees at first. It was a little warm for the wig, so I bumped it down to 280, and it took very well to the heat of 280. So this comes down to, oh my gosh, this comes down to my waist. This is a very long unit. It comes down to the waist. I do love how the ends, like once you straighten it out, is not blunt. Like it is kind of frayed, which gives it a more of a realistic look. But so back to the length. It is, I would say it's about 24 inches. 22 inches comes to the small on my back. 20 inches comes to the small on my back. So yeah, I would give about 4 more inches and that will be what this wig is. So I would definitely say the wig is 24 inches long. I think I did order 24 inches. I'm not sure. So yeah, the lace, as far as in the front, the lace stops right here. So you only get the parting space from here to here. The parting is about 3.5 inches of parting up top. If you want to part it straight down the middle, of course, it's the more you go to the side, it's going to get less and less. I don't really worry about it when it comes to closure type. The fronts, frontals, closure type frontals, because if for me is if I can't part the hair like anywhere I want without their tracks being shown, there's no point. I just do the flip over method. As such, the hair didn't really take too well to the flip over method, meaning that when I try to flip it over, it will flap back. But I just brushed it a few times in that direction and sprayed it with some got to be hairspray, and it stayed. So yeah, as far as the shine goes, it is synthetic, so you can expect some type of shine. One way to dull that down is to use a dry shampoo, which I did. For me, the dry shampoo doesn't completely get the shine out. So there's always gonna be like maybe a little bit of shine left, but it's not to the point of where it looks like a fake shine. It looks more like a healthy shine. And if you can see, look at my edges. So I did glue this wig down. I glued this wig down using Got to Be Glue hair gel and the spray, the black bottle gel, and the, as you can see back there, the yellow bottle of hairspray. And what I do is I pull the wig up first, see where I want it to land, pull it back, put the gel on, take my blow dryer on a cool setting where dry it so where it gets tacky. Then I take the Got to Be Glue hairspray, spray that on top of the gel, do the same method with the blow drying until it gets tacky again, and then I lay my wigs down, and it's sure to stay for a good 3 days tops without budging if you do it that way. I used to do it before where I would only use the glue, or I would spray the glue and the gel at the same time, and for some reason it just wouldn't stay. Like, I don't know, it's the way the method I use now, I guess it's like layering the glue, so it ends up staying longer. Of course, if you want to use other wig adhesives to last longer, you sure can. However, this is a synthetic unit, and it's not really recommended to sleep in a synthetic unit unless you, what I would do at night, like what I'm going to do tonight, is I'm going to pin this up. I'm just going to put it in a ponytail, twist, put my sleeping cap over it, and this way the hair won't get messed up while I'm sleeping. And just in the morning, pull it down and flat iron any crimps out if I need to. If, as you can see, it's not really that much tangling going on at all, which is surprising. It is surprising that there isn't that much tangling because it is a synthetic unit. I don't really expect much from synthetic units. With synthetic units, you know what you're gonna get. You know what you're gonna expect. You're getting a 1 to 2 weeks hairstyle tops if you're wearing the wig consistently, or if you don't get any extras, it's $91 plus shipping. I think it came, like I said, it came to like $109, and it's tangle free, looks good. I'm getting so many compliments. I posted this picture, a couple of pictures on Facebook. I'm getting so many compliments, and it's a synthetic wig. $100-something, and you look like you spent bombshell hair money. So it's still a mommy on a budget situation, okay? Thanks for watching. Hope this helps somebody. Rate, comment, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell after you do so, and I'll see you next time.